Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Somaliland National Television English News Program. My name is Farhad Sheikh Habib, and I'm here to update you with Somaliland and international news. These are the main headlines making news. Somaliland and Ethiopia signed a memorandum of understanding. Ethiopian delegation visits Somaliland-Ethiopian border city of Togbochale. Burkina Faso factionist approved transition plan. Somaliland and Ethiopian government signed a memorandum of understanding in collaboration in terms of strengthening peace and stability in the region and improving economic infrastructure in Somaliland. The agreement came after a lengthy meeting was held in Hargeisa by Somaliland officials and Ethiopian delegation.
The Somaliland and Ethiopian government signed a memorandum of understanding in collaboration in terms of strengthening peace and stability in the region and improving economic infrastructure in Somaliland. The agreement came after a lengthy meeting was held in Hargeisa by Somaliland officials and Ethiopian delegation. Somaliland Minister of Foreign Affairs Mohamed Bihi Yunis and the Ethiopian Minister of Finance and Economic Development Mr. Sufyan Ahmed signed the agreements on behalf of the respective countries. Somaliland Minister of Foreign Affairs briefed the media about the importance of the agreement reached. He stated that Ethiopia has a population of more than 90 million, thus need a port to import their business goods. The Minister of Finance and Economic Development of Ethiopia highlighted areas agreed by the two countries, and he stated,
"We said we just signed a memorandum of understanding to cooperate on the area of infrastructure integration and the trade and the investments. We also agreed to establish a technical team."
The Minister of Finance of Somaliland, who also spoke to the media, stated that this is the largest Ethiopian delegation to visit Somaliland, and he defined the agreement signed as a great achievement.
The President of Somaliland, His Excellency Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanyu, joined by members of Somaliland Cabinet, received the Minister of Finance and Economic Development, who led a large delegation from Ethiopia.
The President of Somaliland, His Excellency Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Zilanyo, joined by a member of Somaliland Cabinet Ministers, recepted the Minister of Finance and Economic Development of Ethiopia, who led a large delegation from Ethiopia. The Minister of Foreign Affairs of Somaliland, Mr. Mohamed Bihi Yunis, spoke to the media and described the strong ties between the two countries. The Minister of Finance of Ethiopia, Sufyan Ahmed, also thanked the President of Somaliland for their reception and stated that integration of economic and business of the two countries will better contribute to the peace and stability of the region.
Members of Somaliland Cabinet Ministers, flanked by high-profile delegation from neighboring nation of Ethiopia, have provided supervisory tour to Togbochale town to assess the progress of the commercial activities. The high-ranking delegation from Somaliland and Ethiopia visited to Togbochale to oversee and assess the trade going on the town, which lies at the boundary line of the two countries. Members of the delegation were initially warmly received by Gebele Regional Governor at Gebele Town, Mustafa Abdi Shine, who escorted them to Togbochale town, which is a common for trade linking between the two nations. Upon the arrival of the delegation to the town, they were received a warm reception by the presidents, whereby the delegates assessed areas including Calabade customs and the various business activities progressing in the town. Somaliland Minister of Presidency Hirsi Ali Haji Hassan, who spoke on the occasion, has briefed about the visit and the objectives of the delegation from Ethiopia came to Somaliland. The minister stated that Togbochale is an important location for trade and plays a significant role in bolstering the trade between Somaliland and Ethiopia. He further stated that it's aimed to oversee the trade and how it's going in order to promote the overall commercial activities of the town, as it lies the boundary line linking the two countries. It has diplomatic relational interests for Somaliland and Ethiopia. Somaliland Minister of Finance, Mr. Abdulaziz Samale, who provided a key remark on the venue, has stressed on the importance of the bilateral diplomatic ties between the two countries. On the other hand, Ethiopian Minister of Finance and Economic Development, speaking on the occasion, briefed the media about the ties and relations that Somaliland and Ethiopia commonly share, and pointed out as well that they are pleased to have extended an assessment visit to the poor town of Berbera and to Gwachale, which makes special interest for them. Ethiopian Minister of Finance and Economy thanked the government of Somaliland for their kind, warm reception. Chairman of Education and Higher Studies of Togdere Region attends a ceremonial graduation by which Candlelight Organization handing over certificates to graduates of computer skills and other programs. The event had an attendance by representative members from Candlelight Organization, Chairman of Education and Higher Studies of Togdere Region, teachers, parents and students. Hassan Chama, the Chairman of Education and Higher Studies of Togdere Region, who provided the opening remark on the venue, has commended efforts made by Candlelight to actively promote education being delivered to the students in the region, and encouraged them to sustain their efforts to upgrade the educational states of the residents in the region. The Deputy Chairman of Candlelight Organization, Mahmoud Saeed, and Engineer Mahmoud Ismail, who is the teacher, trained and educated the students, have collectively enlightened about the importance of the skills they provided to the students, the number they contain, and the quality education they were provided likewise. They encouraged the students to continue improving their studies further and apply it in the workplaces, where they also pointed out the importance and the need of such skills among the people. Finally, members of the graduates spoke at the event and praised the efforts of the teacher, who was in particular training the students and Candlelight Organization, for the hard work to provide them such remarkable comprehensive skills programs. You are still watching English news program on Somaliland National Television, the only Somali-speaking channel with an English news program. And now for our international headlines in detail. Burkina Faso faction approved transition plan, army reaches a deal with opposition, civil groups and religious leaders on blueprint to retain country to civilian rule.
Burkina Faso's army has reached an agreement with opposition parties, civil groups and religious leaders for a transition to civilian rule. Almost 2 weeks after the ousting of President Blaise Compaoré, the different factions unanimously voted in favor of a transition charter on Thursday, said Henry Yi, president of the commission representing the main power players in the West African country. Today was the day of compromise, said Herve Kam, a member of the Blaise City and Civil Society group. Both soldiers and civilians agree on a civilian transition. The institutions of the transition would be led by civilians. The new head of state, who will not be permitted to stand in the elections, will be chosen by a special college composed of 8 religious and traditional leaders and 5 members of each from the army, opposition and civil society. The president will then name a prime minister to appoint a 25-member government. The charter also calls for a 90-member National Transitional Council to serve as legislative body. It will be composed of 30 opposition representatives and 25 members from both the civil society and the army. The remaining 10 seats will go to other political parties, including members of the company's former ruling coalition which did not participate in the negotiations. Lieutenant Colonel Isaac Zeta declared himself head of state on November 1st after Compaoré resigned and fled the country last month amid mass protests against his efforts to change the constitution to seek re-election in 2015 after 27 years in power. Zeta, who has repeatedly pledged to hand over power to a civilian authority, is expected to enact the charter within days, participants in the talk said. On all the points, even where we had differences of opinion among Burkinis, we have reached a consensus. We have a charter that will be promulgated very quickly, opposition leader Seferin Diabre said, following the plan's adoption. According to a draft of the transition blueprint, no members of the interim regime will be allowed to stand in the next election scheduled for November 2015.
Alaska Israel lifts age bar for what she prays men of all ages, allowing to attend main weekly Muslim prayers at Jerusalem's Flashpoint Mosque compound.
Men of all ages will be allowed to attend the main weekly Muslim prayers at Jerusalem's Flashpoint Alaska Mosque compound for the first time in months. No age limit on the Temple Mount. We are hoping things will be calm and quiet today, Mickey Russellfeld told the AFP news agency on Friday. He was using the Jewish term for the old city holy site, known as Haram al-Sharif, by Palestinians that has been the scene of the repeated disturbance for months. He added that extra police units were deployed in Jerusalem this morning to prevent any incidents in and around the old city. Rosenfeld linking the decision to lift age restrictions to thugs in Jordan on Thursday, after which U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry said steps were agreed between King Abdullah II and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to lower tensions at the mosque compound. Firm commitments were made to maintain the status quo at the compound, holy to both Jewish and Muslims in Israel and next to East Jerusalem, Kerry said at a press conference with Jordanian Foreign Minister Nasser Judeh.
That's the end of our English news desk on Somaliland National Television. Until we meet for the next time, goodbye.